Hi guys, so I'm back with a new video and let's talk about the woman in the window. So if you have been following me for a while, if you have been watching my videos, you might have seen this movie come up in two of my most anticipated videos, because this movie is like really long overdue. Like, this was supposed to come out in 2018, if I'm not mistaken, either 2018 or 2019. This is a New Mutants type of movie that for some reason has been postponed. And yeah, I'm finally seated here to talk about it. Finally, like, Netflix picked it up like later last year or earlier this year. I'm not entirely sure. I just know that I filmed my most anticipated video for this year, and just like after filming it, I found out that the movie was coming out really this year, that it was picked up by Netflix. So yeah, it is available to everyone. Maybe it would have been a good thing to watch it at the cinema, but like this, maybe it's more available to everyone and maybe more people watch it. I don't know what the deal was, why this took so long to come out. If you do, let me know. But yeah, we're here to talk about it, so let's do it. If you don't know what The Woman in the Window is about, this is based on a book by the same name, and I have not read the book, so I can't really comment on how accurate this is. So if you have read the book, let me know in the comments how it compares. But basically, The Woman in the Window is about a woman with agoraphobia, so she can't leave her house, and while she's in her house, she witnesses a gruesome murder while she's spying on her neighbors. So she can't leave the house, so her hobby is to see what everyone else is doing around her, and she sees a crime being committed. So yeah, the cast for this movie is like really packed. It has a lot of big names. The main actress is Amy Adams, but it also stars Gary Oldman, Fred Ettinger, I'm not sure how you pronounce his name, Julianne Moore. It also stars Anthony Mackie, Wyatt Russell. Yeah, there's a lot of big names here, and I was like really shocked because I don't know, I only knew Amy Adams was in this, and that was enough for me, to be honest. Actually, I was into it because of the plot, but then after finding out that Amy Adams would be like the main character, yeah, it looked like a pretty good one. Post that, let's see how this turned out. So I think I have to start by saying that just the fact that we're here to talk about it, just the fact that I watched it, that alone just makes me happy. But I did enjoy the movie. I think the story is pretty captivating. It is told in a really interesting and intense, intriguing way. And yeah, I was invested throughout the whole movie. So that was great. Also, the cast was really good. Obviously, we know these actors, we know what they're capable of, and yeah, they do an amazing job. Obviously, Amy Adams is amazing. But actually, I have to talk like about Gary Oldman, who I'm not like his biggest fan. I don't have anything against him, but he's not like an actor that I really, really like. But he really surprised me in this, because his performance was the reason why I guessed the ending. And that can be a good and a bad thing. Like, his acting was on point. It drove across the emotions and what it was supposed to let you know about his character and all the other characters, so that is nice. But then his performance was so good that it gave away the ending, at least for me, like I guessed it because of him. Up until one particular scene with Gary Oldman's character, I had no idea what was going on. There are some things that I didn't guess, obviously, but like the very end and like the main mystery, yeah, I guessed it, and although I'm not really bummed about it, yeah, I would have liked to be surprised. As for the cinematography and the directing like choices, I liked most of it. Like, I enjoyed everything, even the little cheesy things, like there's some splatter editing and there's some interesting things in there which might be a bit cheesy, but I was okay with it up until like the last 20 minutes where the movie gets like way too cheesy for me. It leans way too much into the 2000s horror movie thing, like the cringiness of that era, and more specific like the horror movies, it gets like really deep into that, and yeah, I was cringing a little bit in those last 20 minutes. But overall, I'm not mad at the cinematography and like the choices that were made. So overall, I liked the movie. I have seen some really negative reviews. I don't think it is that bad. I was invested, I was intrigued. The story was good, the acting was good, the cinematography was good for the most part. So yeah, I think this was maybe one of the best movies that I've seen this year. I haven't seen a lot, but maybe one of the best, and yeah, I'm just glad I finally watched it. So if you liked The Girl on the Train and Gone Girl, I think you'll like this one. Post that, let's get into my scores. So overall, I give the movie a 3.5 out of 5. As I said, I was really interested in the whole thing, so yeah, this might be one of the higher scores that people have been giving the movie. I have seen a lot of 2s and 2.5s and even 1s, so yeah, I enjoyed it and I recommend it. As for the cinematography, I give it a 3 out of 5. As I said, the majority of the movie was good in my opinion, but those last 20 minutes weren't really my favorite, so I had to bump it down like maybe 0.5 star or maybe 1 star. So 3, I think it's a fair score. And for the originality, I also give it a 3 out of 5. This was a tough one because I don't think the movie is 100% original. As I said, I compared this to The Girl on the Train and Gone Girl, but I liked the agoraphobia aspect. It really hasn't been done a lot. The only time that I've seen this in a movie was one of the Into the Dark episodes, which was actually one of my favorites. So yeah, and there's some other things, so I don't think it's super original, but it's above average. So yeah guys, these are my thoughts on The Woman in the Window. As I said, I didn't read the book, so I don't know how it compares. As a movie alone without the book, I liked it, but if you have read the book, let me know in the comments if the movie stayed true to the book, because I would love to know that. I'm not really planning on reading the book, but who knows, if you tell me that it's really different, I might read the book. I've seen people say that the book is pretty good. I just want to know if it is similar to the movie, like if the movie follows the actual story of the book. And even if you only watched the movie, let me know what you thought of the movie, if you enjoyed it like I did, or if you were disappointed like most people. I enjoyed it, as I said, so yeah. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you're not subscribed yet, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!